Born in Wichita, Kansas, Joe Walsh began playing guitar in junior high school after watching the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show in 1964. He built a considerable reputation as lead guitarist and lead vocalist for the notorious Cleveland-based James Gang. Such Walsh tunes as Funk 49, Tend My Garden, Walk Away, and The Bomber redefined the sound and concept of the power trio. Earning high critical praise and 3 gold albums. The success of the James Gang brought wide popularity and endless touring, and as the big bucks beckoned, Walsh turned the other way. In 1971, encouraged by his friend, producer Bill Simzik, Walsh made the difficult decision to leave the James Gang and relocate to the open air of Colorado's Boulder County. Taking my time, choosing my lines, trying to decide what to do. For months, he lived in the mountains and practiced ham radio operations. Full-time exposure to the rural landscape and easygoing rustic lifestyle in the small towns of the Rockies seeded a new perspective.
Joe and I both wanted him to start a solo career because he was somewhat limited in the James Gang, and he wanted to stretch out, and so did I, for that matter. We wanted to make more Beatlesque, orchestral, you know, large-scale things instead of power trio things.
Walsh emerged with full force in 1972, forming a new group called Barnstorm with an old colleague and a newfound friend. Joe Vitale, a confrere from their lean and hungry days at Kent State University and a refugee from the band Amboy Dukes, was 5'5" of talent and energy on drums, timpani, gong, flute, and synthesizer. Bassist Kenny Passarelli hailed from Colorado and provided a perfect complement to the music Walsh was bent on creating. Barnstorm was the first album ever recorded at Caribou Ranch, the facility high above Boulder that would soon gain fame as a destination studio. A long winter and spring at Caribou served Walsh and his band. Simzik handled the production and took care of the mixing.
It was really different. It was really out in the middle of nowhere. Especially Netherland. Netherland was in the middle of nowhere. But I remember going to Caribou Ranch and just being, my mind couldn't grab it. I couldn't comprehend what he had up there.
The studio became their playground. Walsh moved away from the hard rock sound of the James Gang and explored his love of lushly textured production, and he freely indulged himself with spacey, open-ended songs. Passarelli and Vitale proved themselves adept at handling Walsh's beautiful choruses, country tinges, and pastoral pop hooks. He experimented with running his guitar straight into a Leslie 122 to get swirly, organ-like guitar tones. And he utilized the ARP Odyssey synthesizer to great effect on such songs as Mother Says and Here We Go. The music ranged to the lone hard rock track on Barnstorm, Turn to Stone. Barnstorm was a critical success. Record World found the album of laid-back fantasia oh so tasteful, while Cashbox applauded the genius arrangements and stunning harmonies. The stage held its own magic, and Walsh built a larger Barnstorm band for the road, adding keyboardist Rocky Grace and later Tom Stevenson. Accompanied once again by Passarelli and Vitale, Walsh officially went solo the following year with his second album, The Smoker You Drink, The Player You Get. Its title growing evidence of his comic persona. It was a commercial breakthrough. Recorded at Caribou Ranch with Simzik producing, the album became the first top 10 hit of Walsh's career. It went on to sell more than 1 million copies. 2 songs received heavy airplay and opened up a massive audience for Walsh and his band. Meadows. Rocky Mountain Way, the classic rock nugget inspired by Walsh's move to Colorado. Co-written by Passarelli, Walsh's signature tune was a perfect vehicle for his soaring slide guitar work and distinctive reedy tenor. Spare the last
I had the music done at Criteria, but it wasn't Rocky Mountain Way, it was just some track I had. I had no idea what it was going to be called. One day of a caribou, I just turned around, and there was the back range with just covered with snow and everything, and it just kind of, wow. What? And having moved and left the James Gang and going to Colorado, Rocky Mountain Way, better than the way we had. I mean, I just said, this is a great place. And you could just tell that the environment affected the music.
Barnstorm disbanded amicably in 1975, allowing Walsh to produce Dan Fogelberg's Souvenirs album and to work at a less hectic pace on his third solo album. So What included the songs Welcome to the Club and a remake of Turn to Stone. During the recording of So What, Walsh invited members of the Eagles to contribute background vocals. At the end of 1975, Bernie Ledden departed the Eagles, who, facing a tour of Australia and the Orient, drafted Walsh to join them. That led to a full-time collaboration between Walsh and the hugely popular West Coast country rock quintet. Walsh's addition gave the band a much-needed harder-edged sound, most notably on Hotel California, their biggest-selling album, on which he co-wrote the hit Life in the Fast Lane. Walsh's Eagles tenure gave him enhanced visibility, and he continued his pattern of successful solo albums. Walsh remains one of the most colorful characters in rock music. Passarelli played with a variety of musicians, including Elton John, Dan Fogelberg, Stephen Stills, and Hall & Oates. Vitale continues his longtime partnership with Walsh. He also appeared with Fogelberg, the Eagles, and Crosby, Stills & Nash.